6 days away from the eclipse, we wanted to talk to a NASA scientist about what exactly that's going to look like.
The story from WGNO's Kenny Lopez.
Solar eclipses happen somewhere in the world about every year and a half, but most of them aren't in our own backyard. From Texas to Maine, people across 15 states will have a front row seat to seeing the moon covering the bright disk of the sun, briefly turning day into night.
If you can take a few minutes out of your day to see that peak eclipse, it will really be a life-changing experience.
NASA's Dr. Gina DiBraccio witnessed the last total solar eclipse back in 2017. But this year, her anticipation is still out of this world.
I understand that every eclipse is a little bit different. So the first thing is that we have more people living within the path of totality this time. So for this eclipse, we have about 31 million people in the path, which is more than double what happened in the 2017 eclipse. Now, for 2017 as well, totality didn't last as long as it will this time. So now we're looking at a maximum of about 4.5 minutes. So longer time and more people experiencing this eclipse.
While Louisiana isn't in the path of totality, it will still be a sight to see.
For your partial eclipse, you'll get to see a partial eclipse still. And what that means is that as you look up in the sky, you will get to see the moon moving over the sun. It won't block it completely, but you'll be left with what looks like a crescent sun, or what we describe as a Pac-Man almost, the moon taking a bite out of the sun so that you can see it covering.
That's perfect for the Crescent City. That's what they call New Orleans.
Now, you'll still have different experiences that you'll feel too. The temperature will drop, the atmosphere will change a little bit.
For NASA, the total eclipse is an opportunity to further their research for future missions.
We're able to study the solar corona, that upper atmosphere of the sun, is answer the questions of how does physics operate on the sun.
This time is proving to be a great time in outer space.
We won't have another eclipse crossing through the U.S. for another 20 years, so this really is an opportunity that we have coming up on Monday.
As always, when viewing a solar eclipse, make sure to wear your safety glasses to protect your eyes. Kenny Lopez, WGNO News.
And in our area, you can expect to see the eclipse around its peak between 1 and 2 in the afternoon.